Hello everyone, I am Sudarshan Kesava Narayanan and I am a Microsoft MVP. This is my first year getting an MVP. And these are all my blog site, spknowledge.com, and couple of social links you can connect me in. So today we are going to see how we can synchronize photos from Azure AD or file shares into SharePoint user profile service. As you all know, there are many ways users or administrators can upload photos to Office 365, like via M365 Admin Center, via Azure AD, and also via Delve. But none of it will synchronize with SharePoint UPS, even if the Azure Active Directory is connected to on-premise. Most of the properties are synced, but photo is not synced. And there are a couple of solutions which are already available, like there is an core profile uploader from Patterns and Practices, where it is a separate console application where you can get all your photos gathered in a file share, and then a couple of configurations which you have to update it. And then by running this tool, it will create different thumbnails, and then it will update your user profile. There are a couple of configurations and settings which you have to do to synchronize using this tool. And mostly, there is an article which explains how the photos are displayed in Office 365. Particularly, if the clients are having an exchange online, then obviously the photos will be synced. Whenever the user access the SharePoint site, it will automatically display from the exchange online. And if they are not using exchange online, then it is pulled from the Delve and other resources. So the features, the user selection. So I have provided two tabs, like a first one which will allow the users to select a couple of users so that they can upload, they can synchronize only the particular user's photo. And there is also a bulk sync where you can drag and drop a bulk of images, and then you can update it. The only thing is the images should have the file name as user login name, which is the user principal name, which looks like an email ID. And the other feature is access control. This solution can be accessed only by a specific set of people, which can be configured in the WebPart properties, a SharePoint group, which can be configured. Not all the end users can access this solution. And there is also a feature where you can view whoever has uploaded the photos. There is a status, a synchronization job status. You can verify whether the job is running or it is already completed or is there any error. And the last is I have used Azure function, Azure PNP PowerShell, to handle the photo update. And a couple of packages have used this, mostly the PNP packages. And I am a great fan of PNP package, and it is a very helpful library. And mostly it is very easy to maintain the code using that library. And a couple of property controls and SPFX controls. And image resize, where I have used to generate different thumbnails. And React drop zone is nothing but for drag and drop functionality. So let's go to the demo. So before going to the demo, let me refresh the profile page. It will load on the back end. Actually, there are two users, Alex and Diego, where I will show it by manual selection, and Grady and Henry, where I will drag and drop the images, and then I'll show that functionality. So this properties will only be, for the first time, it will be loading only to the site administrators. So when the end users click on edit this web part, and they cannot see all the properties. And the first one is the library, where I'll be storing the different thumbnail images for the temporary purpose. And the Azure function will get the images from this library and then store it in UPS. And There is an option to delete. If once the job is already done, you can keep the thumbnail images for any other purpose, or you can just select this property so that once the properties are updated, then automatically the thumbnail images will be deleted. And this is Azure function URL and whether to use certificate or not. And the date time is nothing but the status, sync job status. And this is a SharePoint group, whoever can access this web part. And this is to enable whether you need to enable the bulk sync or not. And use page full width is nothing but here I have created as a spa. And you can also add this as a web part, where if you want to use the full page, you can just select this option. So the first one is Alex and Diego. So let me choose the name. So you can see here the photos are not updated. So if you see here, the photos are not updated. And Diego. Okay, so once you select it, I'll be displaying the title, user ID, and then the current photo from SharePoint. And once you click this button, so this will get the photo from Azure AD. So if you see for Alex, you can see the photo here, and for Diego, there is a photo. And you can see the photos will be displayed here. And if there is no photo, then only the profiles which has the photo will be taken into consideration by the Azure function to update. And the last is you can click the update for users' photos. So once you click on this button, it will trigger the Azure functions on the back end, and then it will the job will trigger on the back end. So that's it. So when you go to the sync status, so you can see the status as the manual trigger, and the job is submitted. So regarding the bulk sync, so I have provided the message that it can support PNG, JPEG, and JPG. The only thing is the file name should have the user's login name. So I'll just choose. So once you selected this, then based on the file name, I'll be getting their user ID and then the title. And then I'll be displaying the current image, whichever from SharePoint. So I'll be showing the status whether it is valid or not. If the name doesn't match from the site users column, then it will shows invalid. So just trigger the button. That's it. So this will automatically generate the image and then put it in the folder, and then it will trigger the Azure function. So these are all, this is the user photos library, which is a temporary library I have been using. So if you see here, it has generated all the thumbnails for the first scenario. Okay. And there is a sync list which I have been using where to store all the sync data. So I have been storing the sync data and then the completed data from the Azure function as a JSON file. So once the process is completed, so let us check the status. So the manual status, Alex and Diego, it is completed. So the status is changed and this is running. So if you can see the actions, so you can see the profile is updated. So this is Alex. I'll just refresh it. And let me see whether. Okay, the bulk sync, it is also completed. So you can see Grady and Henrik. So if you see here, Alex, their photos are getting up, it's updated, and Diego, it is also updated. And for Grady and Henry, it is also updated. And the main thing is on the back end, the photos are getting stored in the My Site. So all the thumbnails and everything is getting stored in the My Site. And once you delete the photos from here, automatically the thumbnails are removed from here. So it is just for your information. Okay, so let's see the code. So this is a sample JSON file that I'll be sending it to the Azure function, which has the admin URL, my site URL, and the target site URL where I have to fetch the library and then the picture folder, and whether we are using the certificate or not, and item ID in case after the sync job is completed, it has to update the list item. So I'll be sending the item ID, and then the value, whether whoever wants to update the photo, their username, and then what is the file name. So I'll be mapping it with an extension in my code. So on the packages, as I have already mentioned, I have been using all the PNP packages and image resize to generate the thumbnail. So on the web part properties, so first I'll be checking the user, current logged in user, whether he is a site admin or the normal user. If it is a site admin, I'll be loading all the properties here. And if it is a normal user, I'll be just loading the property pan information so that they can ask the administrators to change or add any other user they want to access it. And apart from it, in init, I have just sent the context to the SP. And this is a file, photosync. The main component file. So basically for different tab, I have been using different components. So the main thing in this file is I'll be calling the prepare function here, Azure, to generate the JSON and then to send it to the Azure function. So this is the main thing. All the other functionalities are defined in the helper file. So in this helper file, you can see I have been using the PNP and then graph. And these are all the sizes. And if you see actual SP photo sizes, it will generate three thumbnails, small, medium, and large. Small is 48x42. And the actual, the corresponding size from the graph service is 48x48. And if you see, there are multiple dimensions you can get it from the graph. So these are all the width and height of the photo. These are all different dimensions you can get it. And in that, I am using 48x48 for small, 96 for medium, and then 240 for large. So the functionality to get the photo from Azure, I am using the graph service, and then I'm generating the thumbnails using the graph. I'm just getting all the thumbnail photo using the graph service. And if it is uploaded via file share, means I am using the image resize to generate different thumbnails for these dimensions. And one more thing is I have just created a batch limit, because since we are using graph, we cannot send each and every request individually. So I am using the batch limit. So if there are more number of requests, I'll batch it the maximum of 18, and then I'll send it as a batch. So you see here, I'll be splitting all the requests into a chunk. And then if it reaches 18, I'll be sending it in a multiple batches. And this is the endpoint user/photos and what is the dimension and then to value, so that it will return a blob. So I'm just returning it as a response type as blob. So it will return a blob type, and then I'll store it in the document library. And this is regarding the graph. And using the image resize, it is just a simple and very powerful. So a simple method, just play, and then you can just pass in the size, and then it will create a, it will return a blob, and then the same method, you can just save it into the document library. So, and at last, the function to call the Azure functions. Okay. And next is PowerShell script. Here, based on the JSON, I'll be fetching all the thumbnails, large, medium, and then small. And then I'll be setting the medium thumbnails as a photo URL. And one more property, which we have to set it as a picture placeholder state. So this state has to be set once the URL is, picture URL is set. And other than that, if you have selected the function to clear the photos, then automatically once the photo has been updated, it will automatically remove it from the document library. That's it, Patrick. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you very much. That's really interesting demo. A great use of the files and the different ways to manipulate the images with the resizing. another great sample. Encourage folks to check that out.